Hello folks, welcome to our next video in the Power Platform for Educators series here on YouTube. Stay tuned to our channel for things outside of this video, from Azure to SQL to the whole Power Platform. But what I wanna go back into is what we have been discussing. We're gonna go back to our Power Virtual Agent, now called a Copilot, but still in Teams, it still says Power Virtual Agents. And we're gonna add some more things to it. And what I wanna showcase is how we can use Power Automate inside of our Copilot Power Virtual Agent and have it kick off a flow to do something for us. And in this case, we're gonna make a new record on a data source. Now I'm gonna tell you some more details about that, which are, our idea is we want to have our students come into the Copilot, say, hey, I need help with tutoring. And we're gonna get some details about that tutoring request. We're gonna store it on a data source so that the teacher can look at those at the end of the day. So without any further ado, let's head on over and see how we can get it executed. Before we begin, if you are interested in learning more about the Power Platform, please go to prag.work/map40, where you will get 40% off our on-demand learning subscription, which has access to over 100 different courses. Let's get on to the video. All right, so I'm in the Copilot that I've been creating for a few of our other episodes. We're about to make a new topic, but to set it up here, I did some pre-work. I made a SharePoint list where I'm gonna just capture some information. My title column I'm gonna use for the name of the student, the day that they want tutoring, what's it gonna be about, and do they have transportation when the tutoring is over? That was always an important one for me when I was a former educator. So I didn't have to wait an hour after we were done to get the student picked up. So let's come back on over to our Power Virtual Agents, and I'm gonna come up to the top here. I'm in my topics area. And I'm gonna click new topic and a topic from blank. Now, as we learned in earlier sessions, you should always have 5 to 10 trigger phrases. I wanna keep this quick and simple, so I'm just gonna make it tutoring help. So I'm only gonna put in one trigger phrase here. All right, then I'm gonna put in a generic message. I can help you make a tutoring request. And I'll stop there. So then the first thing I'm gonna ask them is a question. Now again, I'd probably put more messages and information, make it really friendly, but we want to get straight to the point. So I'm going to click ask a question here, and I'm going to say, what day would you like tutoring? And then I'm going to keep my identify here as a multiple choice option, and I'm going to give them a few options. Now, I would give them a lot more here, but we're going to keep it simple. I'm just going to go Tuesday. I'll say Wednesday, always the hard day of the week to spell. And then finally, I'll put in one more Thursday, because I'm not going to stay on a Friday. As a former educator, I was ready to get out of there, right? I'm going to collapse this over here to make this a little bit easier to see. And anytime you put in this multiple choice option in your Teams Copilots, it starts off with these conditions. It's kind of nice. It's what I use a lot of the time. But in this case, I don't want that. So I'm going to delete these conditions here, because I need to ask them another question. So I'm gonna come up here and I'm gonna add a node. But before I do that, I don't like that it's just called var. So I'm gonna change the name of my variable. This is gonna help me out a little bit later. And what I'm gonna call this is var day, just like so. All right, and then I'll close out of my properties, var day. Now my next one, I'm gonna ask another question and tell me the areas you want help with, please. And then for the identify, I want to collect everything that they type in, so their entire response. And then I'm going to change the name of this variable to var tutoring topic, something along those lines. And then I'll close out of here. Then my last question is, will you have transportation? So I'll ask one more question. Do you have a ride after we are done? And then we could go with an entity. We could put a multiple choice option in here. Again, I'm just gonna go with user's entire response, because maybe they're gonna give me some more information about that transportation idea. So I'm gonna change this variable over here to var transportation. So again, we're just asking three different questions here. Now, normally I would come on over. You know what, not normally. Let's do it here. So I'll add a node. I'm going to show a message and I'm gonna say, I see you want help on, you know, let's bring in that variable value. You want help on a certain day covering, let's bring in what their topic is here. I'll just put that part in and then I'll say I'll send the request for you to your teacher. All right, so now we got all that part set up. Now we get into the kicking off of the Power Automate. So the way that we do this is we come on over here and we add in a node. And we're going to go to call an action. When we go to call an action, we are going to create a flow. So right here, I'm going to click on create a flow. And it says, are you sure you want to leave? Ooh, I haven't saved my stuff yet. So let me say, don't leave yet. Let me save the work that I've done up until this point. And now we're going to kick off the flow. And so everything, if you know anything about Power Automate, maybe watch some of my other videos, we can kick off flows from Power Automate as well. And what we're going to do is we're going to pass in these values that the user has put into the chat here. We're going to pass them into flow. Flow is going to take the values and make the record. In this case, I'm going to do it on a SharePoint list. And then we're going to give them a message in return. So that's going to be the idea here. Try to keep things automated and let Copilot do it for us. So once I've done my saving here, I'm going to click back on my add a node action. I'm going to call an action and I'm going to create the flow. So I'll give it a few seconds to load up here. All right, so we have some templates that we can go with. And the template that we're going to go with is the virtual agent's flow template. This allows you to pass values to the flow and allow the flow to pass values back to your user. So this is the one that we're going to click here, the Power Virtual Agent's flow template. Now it has a pretty awful name up here, so I'm going to change that to my tutoring flow. And then it comes right here to add an input. This is saying, give me the areas of information that you want me to collect from the Copilot conversation, the Power Virtual Agent conversation. So I'm going to click add an input, and these are all going to be text values. So for my first text one, I'm going to call this student because I'm going to capture the name of the student directly from the conversation. Now, the name you give it here does not matter. This is for your reference. Your users do not see this. So I'm going to add in another text input. And this one is going to be for my day. So this will be the day of the week that they're requesting. I'm going to add in another one. I'll call this one my topic, or I'll call it, you know, tutoring topic. Then I'll add in another one, another text input. And this is going to be the transportation. So again, what I'm trying to do in this flow is I'm going to pass in four values from the conversation to the flow. And once those values are passed in, then I can use those values in any of my flow actions. And in this case, I'm going to use those values to go over and create a record on that SharePoint list. So let's do that next piece here. So the next piece I'm going to add in is after those values are passed in, I'm going to click insert a new step. I'm going to add an action. And for this one, because I know what it's called on SharePoint when you want to make a new record, it's called create item. So I'm just going to search for create item here. And then I'm going to click on create item. Then the next thing they want me to do is choose the site that I'm going to create this item on. So my site is my Matt's app site. So I'm going to come on over. I'm not going to go hunt for it. I'm just going to start typing in Matt's app site. Then I need to choose my list. So my list here is my tutoring request list. And then I will select it. We'll give it a second to find its stuff. And now it says, hey, these are the columns on your list. What do you want to put in? Well, I don't want to hard code the information. I want to say, hey, use the information that was passed into you from the Copilot conversation. So we just start mapping the correct values over, which we call our dynamic content. So for the title, I'm going to use the input of student. For the requested day, I'm going to choose my day. For my tutoring topic, I'll choose my tutoring topic. And then for my transportation home, I'm going to choose my transportation. So now you can see I've taken those input values. I'm going to pass them into the create item action. And then if all goes according to plan, it's going to make that record for me. Now, if this was more of an official one, I would do some more things here. I would add in a message to the student after this is done. Here's your request that was made. You'll get a follow-up email if your teacher can meet with you. And I would put a new flow to kick off after that for an approval of the action. I wouldn't put it in the agent itself, but I'd have a separate flow called an automated flow that anytime a new record is made on this list, send the teacher the email with all the details and they'll approve or reject. If they hit approve, send an email or a Teams message to the student that says, hey, Mr. Peterson can meet with you. Or if he hits reject, hey, he's got other plans, he can't meet with you. Again, we're gonna keep it basic, but wanna give you some ideas of other things that you could add to it. So now that we have this part set up, this is where you have your return values. So if I had any actions that were gonna collect extra data and I wanted to return that back to the conversation, I could go to the return values and add in my outputs. In this case, I don't have any that I want to be returned. So I'm simply gonna come up here and I'm going to hit save. So again, this is now saving. And just to prove on my current SharePoint list, I have no data. That is going to change once we attach this Power Virtual Agent to the Power Automate flow that we have created. All right, so it's now called my tutoring flow. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna close out of the flow designer here. This should take me back into my topic. And then now that the flow is created, when I come back on down to the end of my conversation here that I've stopped at, when I go to the add a node and I go to call an action, there we see it, tutoring flow. Now, if I click on view flow details, this is what would take me back to the flow designer, but I'm just ready to use it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just click on my tutoring flow. And notice here are the inputs that I had asked for. So it's saying, hey, this flow needs inputs to do its job. Where are your values coming from? Well, they're gonna be coming from my variables. So I just need to map the variables right on over into the inputs area. So for my student, I'll hit the dropdown and I'm gonna say the bot.user display name. So when my student logs in to use the Copilot, it's gonna capture their display name. So that's picture perfect. For the day, I'm gonna choose that var day where they chose a day. For my tutoring topic, I'm gonna go with my tutoring topic variable. And then finally for my transportation, I'm gonna go with my transportation variable. And then the flow is going to execute. Then, after the flow is done, I want to let my student know your request has been put in. So I'll just put in a simple little message here. So I'll show a message. Your request has been added to Mr. Peterson's list. And then here again is where I put the other message, wait for an email to see if he approved it or rejected it. We're not going that deep into this one. So what we're going to do is we're now just going to click on save up here. After our Copilot conversation topic here has been saved, we should be able to test this out and we should be able to make a record. So I'm gonna open up my test bot panel over here. All right, and I'm gonna simply come on over and put in tutoring help for my message. Then I'll select it, that should engage this topic. I love it. What day would you like tutoring? I'll say, hey, I would like it on Wednesday. Tell them the areas you want help with. We'll say two-step equation solving for X. All right, we'll send that one off. So it's capturing all these variable values as we're doing it. Do you have a ride after we done? I can be picked up at 5. And then I'll send that one off. So now it's gotten all the values. It has then gone to the flow. The flow went fairly quickly. And because the flow was successful, we now see your request has been added to Mr. Peterson's list. But did it really get added there? The moment of truth. I'm gonna go back to my SharePoint list here. I'm gonna refresh my list. And there we go, Matt Peterson, that's me. There's my Wednesday, the tutoring topic, the transportation, I can be picked up at 5. And we have now successfully used Power Automate inside of our Copilot / Power Virtual Agent. So it's just one idea of something that you might want to put in. You might have some automated processes you would like to put into your Copilots for your students, for your employees at the organization, or whatever it might be. But hopefully you got some ideas. You have something that you can use right out of the box. And if that is the case, then I'm glad that you watched this video. Stay tuned for more videos, not just from me, from all of our other excellent trainers on all sorts of different Microsoft products. And hopefully we'll be seeing you sometime in one of our next ones. Thanks so much.